described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Is it.org presents Inventing the Future.
So, who really invented the internet? Or the computer? Or that cell phone in your pocket? We know who invented the light bulb.
Thomas Edison.
And the guy who figured out how to mass produce the automobile.
Henry Ford.
Both hired lots of people and helped grow the American economy. But that was a long time ago.
In an old photo, a large building is built beside a river.
About that same time, in 1930, this building opened in Chicago. The Merchandise Mart was the largest building in the world. 4 million square feet large.
It's shown in present day, where people walk through a shopping area inside.
Today, in addition to massive wholesale businesses, it's home to business incubators, like this one called 1871. People gather here to start new businesses and to find support for their new ideas.
A chalkboard lists different workshops and meetings.
There are people here with great ideas, but to launch a business, they need money.
A man wears headphones and a laptop.
There are people out there with money who are looking for a great idea, and they're not afraid of risk. I'll bet you've never heard of Tom Perkins, Arthur Rock, or Don Valentine. They backed inventors like Rob Campbell, Len Bosack, and Sandy Lerner. Never heard of them either? How about Steve Jobs? You've heard of him, right? These are people who created partnerships that changed the world. Their tools were ingenuity, commitment, hard work, and something called venture capital.
A headline, the man who bets on men.
Venture capital is when people invest a big chunk of money to help start or expand a business. The people who do this are called venture capitalists. Sometimes they fail and lose it all. And sometimes they succeed beyond anyone's wildest expectations.
Like a $1.4 million investment in a Tandem Computers, later sold for $3 billion.
These people and the entrepreneurs they finance are inventing the future. And we should be very happy they've been willing to put their money at risk because we all benefit. These are the people who are behind most of the recent advancements in communication, computer, and medical technology. So, shouldn't we be thankful that we live in a country that's produced so many great inventions because people have had the freedom to invest their money in new ideas, even if there was no guarantee of success?
In an old photo, a man gives Steve Jobs a check.
The combination of entrepreneurship and venture capital have always been, and remain, an essentially American phenomenon. American entrepreneurs, backed by venture capitalists, continue to improve the lives of millions of people here at home and around the world. Now that's a big idea.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.